Welcome back. Golden Horse has emerged as one of the hot new Kiwi music acts. Their songs have been described as intelligently crafted pop, and here performing the latest single from their debut album Riverhead is Golden Horse.
All leave and let go. There is nothing to hold us. In a moment of time, when the fruit becomes wine and the thought becomes the memory, all your sorrow, maybe tomorrow, will fade away in the air. Trying to please me, making it easy. It won't be there in your life, in your life. There's a story I know, we all leave and let go. There is nothing to hold us. In a moment of time, when the fruit becomes wine and the thought becomes a memory, all your sorrow, maybe tomorrow, will fade away in the air. Trying to please me, making it easy, it won't be there, it won't be there in your life, in your life. In your life, oh, in your life.
Fantastic. What a gorgeous sound. That was Golden Horse. And shortly, Kirsten and Jeff from Golden Horse are going to be joining me for a bit of a chat. But while they catch their breath, let's take another peek at this week's fantastic prize line.
Enjoy endless pan, rotisserie and side wok burner. And to keep track of those barbecue utensils, there's both a storage cabinet and drawer. To be in to win Good Morning's ultimate summer prize, all you do is ring 0900 66 333. Ring anytime between now and 11:30 on Friday. That number again, 0900 66 333.
Well, you've heard the music, now let's meet Kirsten Morrell and Jeff Maddock from Golden Horse. Welcome to the program. That was such a pretty song. It was also a finalist at the Silver Scroll Award,
yeah, too. Yeah, two nights ago, yeah.
Do you write all the music?
The two of us write the music, and yeah, together.
Uh-huh. Your music's been described as intelligent, handcrafted pop. I mean, who are your influences?
Oh, so many things yeah. Influence you when you make music, you know. It's hard to pull out a couple of things in the bag and say they shape me, because there's just too many of them, really.
We've got a lot of influences, yeah. Sort of 70s, I suppose.
I don't know.
Is it sounds? Is it people? Is it environment?
It's definitely music. Mm. Yeah, other
just
music.
Great songs, I suppose, in whatever form they come in, you know.
Yeah.
So how did you all get together?
I had a solo sort of act, mm-hmm, about 4 years ago, and we had a big studio, and these guys did, Bressa, Crit and Cake, and I just started playing with them in that sort of arena, just parties and stuff like that.
And that's how you got together?
Yeah.
And Kirsten, I believe you've trained in opera, is that correct?
Yeah.
You performed in any stage production?
Yeah, I'm in the New Zealand Opera Chorus, yeah. So I'm employed by them each year.
But your focus is more, say, pop orientated?
Yeah, yeah.
Your career is, you're wanting your career to go down that path?
Yeah, I mean, the opera's great. I think, if anything, it just helps me look after my voice, but mm-hmm. the two things are very separate.
And Jeff, the three members of Golden Horse, do you work full-time for the group? Is it a full-time gig?
Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't, actually. Working in this sort of industry, you get intense periods of work and you get periods of no work, so if you're prepared to accept that, then...
You know, so what do you do in those periods when there's no work?
Oh, I don't know, just try not to spend all the money.
And have a little faith.
Yeah.
Where did the name Golden Horse come from? Apart from maybe the obvious.
Yeah. I don't know, I think each band plays this thing called the name game, where you sit around for... It can be weeks or months or years, and you just come up with
toss
names.
Toss around with some names, throw some names in.
Yeah,
and
whatever sort of sits well, and that sat well with us.
Now, you have just recorded your album, Riverhead. I mean, you did it yourselves.
Yeah, well, yeah, we had... Tim Finn gave us a whole lot of gear, which was excellent, so in that sense, we had a lot of help.
But you didn't have a record company behind you.
No.
Was that because you couldn't get a deal with a record company?
Yeah, pretty much. You can go down the track of doing lots of demos and keeping on trying to get a record deal, but you may as well just go ahead and make the thing that you really like, you know, and then see what happens.
Where did you record it?
We recorded it in the Waitakere's at the end of Quinn's Road. We built a studio in a house.
Gosh, I mean, how much money does it take? Is it an expensive thing, recording your own album?
It's mostly, it depends on how many things you can borrow off people, really, you know.
Kettles.
Yeah, anything, you know. I mean, it wasn't so expensive for us because we did it slowly when we could, you know.
How long did it take you?
Well, it was recorded over the course of a year. And I mean, that's all stop start sort of stuff.
Right.
But, I mean, it's a long time.
It is a long time.
A long time.
And I mean, within that time, I mean, did you encounter any problems at all, or was it all just sort of smooth sailing for you?
No, it wasn't smooth sailing. I don't know. I don't really, because you're not quite sure how other people do it, but it evolved. Let's say it evolved.
Okay. Was there any worries along the way that perhaps it wasn't going to happen?
Definitely. We were very worried at times that we just wouldn't have the resources to finish it. Yeah, so in fact, towards the end of the album, we were sort of finalising a deal. So that gave us a lot of sort of, it was like, phew, a lot of hope, yeah.
Okay, but in terms of funding it, how did you do that?
Well,
I mean, I know you borrowed a lot of things, money had to come into it somehow.
Yeah. No, I did. I borrowed money off my mum's house and, yeah. It was quite a risk.
Wow. Yep. So your mum always had faith in you, Kirsten. And I mean, in terms of distributing the album,